Hello everyone and welcome to Learnaholic India. So in today's tutorial, we are going to see the popular models of SDLC. So this is the part 3 of the tutorial. So in part 2, we have seen the 3 models, that is waterfall model, iterative model, spiral model and V model. So in this tutorial, we are going to see the remaining 4 models, that is Big Bang model, RAD model, Agile model and software prototyping model. So let's start with the Big Bang model. The Big Bang model is an SDLC model, that is software development lifecycle model. In this model, we do not follow any specific process. In this model, the development just starts with the required money and the effort as the input. The output is the software developed, which may or may not be as per the customer requirement. Even the customer is not sure about what exactly he wants and the requirements are implemented on the fly without much analysis. The design of the Big Bang model. The Big Bang model comprises and focusing of all the possible resources in the software development. In this model, there is no planning required for the coding. The requirements are understood and implemented as they come. It means that whenever the requirement is coming, according to that, the requirements are understood and it is implemented. If any changes are required, then there may not be a complete software designed. Then what are the applications of the Big Bang model? The Big Bang model is ideal for the small projects. When one or two developers are working together, then the Big Bang model is very easy to use. It is useful for academic or practice projects. It is ideal model for the product where the requirements are not understood. The final release date is not given in this model. What are the advantages of Big Bang model? This is a very simple model. There is a very little or no planning required in this model. It is easy to manage, very easy to manage the software, then it is very helpful to use Big Bang model. When very few resources are required, in this model, it gives the flexibility to developers. It is good to learning the newcomers or the student. Then this model is used. What are the disadvantages of Big Bang model? Very high risk and uncertainty. It is not good model for complex and object-oriented project. This is a very poor model for long and ongoing project. This model can turn out to be very expensive if requirements are misunderstood. Let's see the next model, RAD model. The RAD, that is Rapid Application Development model, is based on the prototyping and iterative development with no specific planning involved. The Rapid Application Development focuses on the gathering customer requirement with the help of workshop or focus group, by early testing of the prototypes, by reusing the existing prototypes, that is the components. With the help of continuous integration, the requirements are gathered. Also, with the help of rapid delivery, the requirements are gathered. Next question is, what is rapid application development? Rapid application development is a software development methodology. It uses the minimal planning in favor of rapid prototyping. A prototype is a working model that is functionally equivalent to a component of the product. The functional models are developed in a parallel as prototypes. The modules are integrated to make the complete product for faster product delivery. Let's see the design of the RAD model. The RAD model distributes the analysis, design, build and test phases into a series of short iterative development cycles. These cycles are business modeling, data modeling, process modeling, application generation, testing and turnover. What are the advantages of rapid application development model? The changing requirements can be accommodated in the software development process. The progress can be easily measured. The iteration time can be short with use of powerful RAD tools. Productivity with fewer people in a short time, reduce development time, increase usability of the components, quick initial review occur. This model encourages the customer feedback. What are the disadvantages of RAD model? Dependency on the technically strong team members for identifying the business requirements. Only the system that can be modularized can be built with the help of RAD. This model requires highly skilled developers and designers to understand the requirement. High dependency on modeling skills. Then this model is inapplicable to cheaper projects as the cost of modeling and automated code generation is very high. The management complexity is more. Now let's see where the rapid application model is used. The RAD should be used only when the system can be modularized to be delivered in an incremental manner. It should be used if there is a high availability of the designer for modeling. It should be used only if the budget permits use of the automated code generating tools. The RAD software development lifecycle model should be chosen only if domain experts are available with the relevant business knowledge. Now let's see the next model, Agile model. Agile software development lifecycle model is a combination of iterative and incremental process models. It focuses on the process adaptability and customer satisfaction by rapid delivery of working software product. Agile methods break the product into the small incremental builds. These builds are provided in the iterations. Each iteration typically lasts from about 1 to 3 weeks. Every iteration involves the cross-functional teams working on the various areas like planning, requirement analysis, designing, coding, unit testing, and acceptance testing. A working product is displayed to the customer and the stakeholders. What is Agile? Agile models believes that every project needs to be handled differently. The existing methods need to be tailored to best suit the project requirement. In Agile, the tasks are divided to the time boxes, that is the smaller time frames to deliver the specific feature for a release. Iterative approach is taken and working software build is delivered after each iteration. Each build is incremental in terms of feature. The final build holds all the features required by the customer. So the figure shows the graphical illustration of the model. So the first phase is requirement analysis. In that phase, brainstorming is done. The next phase is design the document and prototyping, in which the designing is done. In the next phase, demand feedback, actual development is done. After that phase, the defects are identified and bugs are resolved, that is the quality assurance test. The next phase is deployment phase, in that the production and technical support is done. After the deployment phase, the product or the software is ready to release in the market. So now we will see the Agile Manifesto principles. Individuals and interactions, in which self-organization and motivation. The next principle is working software, in which demo working software is considered the best means of communication with the customer. The next is customer collaboration, in which continuous customer interaction is important. Next is responding to the change. With responses to the changes and continuous development should be taken care of. What are the advantages of the Agile model? It is very realistic approach to software development system. It promotes the teamwork and cross-training. Agile model requires the minimum resources. The functionality can be developed rapidly and demonstrated very easily. Delivers early partial working solution is the main advantage of the Agile model. It is suitable for fixed or changing requirements. It is a good model for environment that changes steadily. With the help of minimum rules, documentation are easily employed. Which are the disadvantages of the Agile model? This model is not suitable for handling the complex dependencies. In this model, more risk of sustainability, maintainability, and extensibility comes into the picture. The transfer of technology to the new teams may be quite challenging due to the lack of documentation. An overall plan, an Agile leader, and Agile PM practices is must, without which it will not work. This model depends heavily on the customer interaction. So if the customer is not clear about the requirement, the team can be driven in the wrong direction. Now let's see the next model, that is software prototype model. The software prototype refers to building a software application prototypes. It displays the functionality of the product under the development. It may not actually hold the exact logic of the original software. Software prototyping is becoming very popular as a software development model. This model enables to understand the customer requirement at an early stage of the development. So what is software prototyping? Prototype is a working model of the software with some limited functionality. The prototype does not always hold the exact logic of the development. It is an extra effort to be considered under the effort estimation. Prototyping is used to allow the user to evaluate developer proposal and try them out before the implementation. It helps to understand the requirement which are user specific. What is the design approach in the software prototyping? Basic requirement identification. In that, the basic requirements are showcased. The next is developing the initial prototype. In this, the user interfaces is provided. Next is review the prototyping. In this, the feedback is collected in an organized manner. Next is revise the enhanced prototyping. In this, the feedback and review comments are discussed. Let's see the types of software prototyping. First is throwaway or rapid prototyping. It uses a little efforts with less requirement analysis to build a prototype. Next type is evolutionary prototyping. In this, building the actual functional prototype with a minimal functionality in the beginning. The next type is incremental prototyping. In this type, building multiple functional prototypes of the various subsystems and then integrating all the available prototypes to form a complete system. The next type is extreme prototyping. It is used in the web development domain. Let's see the advantages of the software prototyping. It increases the user involvement in the product even before its implementation. The working model of the system is displayed. The user gets a better understanding of the system which is being developed. It reduces the time and cost as the defects can be detected much earlier at the stages of the software development process. This model is quicker because it uses a feedback which is available, leading to a better solution. Missing functionality can be identified easily in this model. Let's see the disadvantages of software prototyping. Risk of inefficient requirement analysis owing too much dependency on the prototype. Users may get confused in the prototypes and actual system. This methodology may increase the complexity of the system as the scope of the system may expand beyond the original plan. The effort invested in the building prototype may be too much if it is not monitored properly. What are the applications of software prototyping? Most useful in the development of the system having the high level of user interaction, such as online systems. System which needs user to fill out form or go through various screens before the data is processed can use the prototyping very effectively to give the exact look and feel even before the actual software is developed. Software which involves too much of data processing and most of the functionality is internal with very little user interface does not usually benefit from the prototyping. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. If you like today's video, then like it, share it with your friends. Also, if you have any query, then comment below. Remember one thing, sharing of knowledge is gaining of knowledge. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you once again.